Welcome back to Arsenal News TV, and today we're going to first look at Arsenal can sign their very own Iron Robin if Edu completes £30 million transfer, and then we're going to look at Mikel Arteta's Arsenal woes can be solved if Gunners sanction huge January transfer. So the first transfer headline states that Arsenal could sign their very own Iron Robin if Edu completes £30 million transfer. So the reports are stating that Gunners are being linked with the move for Sassuolo winger Domenico Berardi, yet to be compared to the former Chelsea and Netherlands star in the past. Arsenal were linked with the move for Sassuolo and Italy star Domenico Berardi over the summer. According to a report from Italian news outlet Gazzetta dello Sport last month, the Gunners showed an interest in the 27-year-old during the summer transfer window. However, a move for the Italy international never materialised, but according to a fresh report from Calciomercato, he has informed Sassuolo of his desire to leave the club in one of the upcoming transfer windows. The Serie A outfit are reportedly asking for around £30 million for Berardi, with around 3 years remaining on his contract at the Mapei Stadium. Arsenal, if they were to make an official move for Berardi, could be about to get a player who has been likened to Iron Robin. The former Netherlands international has a very distinctive style of play, often cutting in on his deadly left foot from the right wing, and this is something Berardi also does, according to Sassuolo's assistant youth coach Luciano Carlino in 2014. For his light touch and ability to cut in with pace, he reminds me of Iron Robin, Carlino said via the Daily Mail around 7 years ago. He has a left foot capable of lethality from any position. Speaking over the summer, Sassuolo CEO Giovanni Carnavelli issued an update on the future of Berardi. He told Tutto Sport, Caputo, Boga, Berardi and Locatelli won't be sold. We received lots of offers for them, but we rejected all of them. We won't give up on our best players because we have an ambitious project with Di Zerbi, with Berardi being the leader of this team. With time remaining on his deal at Sassuolo, the Italian club are not in a position where they absolutely need to sell the winger. So it looks like Arsenal could sign their very own Iron Robin if Edu completes £30 million transfer. And Domenico Berardi is a player that is very versatile in that front three position. He can play as a right winger, he can operate as a striker, and also can operate in sort of a false nine role as well. In terms of Berardi, he can offer something different to Mikel Arteta, but I think this is a transfer that needs to be looked at very carefully, given the fact that we have wingers such as Nicola Pepe and the likes of Smith Rowe, you can operate in either wing, and players such as Bukayo Saka, players such as even Martin Odegaard, can operate in either wing, and even if you want to include the likes of Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang, Gabriel Martinelli, players that can operate in either wing. I think this is a transfer I don't think we should go for, because even though Domenico Berardi is a decent player, I think we will have to rely on players such as Nicola Pepe. He needs that game time, he needs that ability to come, because even though he had some moments where he did look shambolic versus the likes of Norwich City, I think most of the time I think he was a more creative outlet. I think at the start, in the first 5-10 minutes, I thought he was amazing. He was giving the defender problems, and I think if you give him the ball, if you give him time, he will be a top player. We've gave him 2 years now since he signed that £72 million deal. But this nicely takes us on to the second piece of transfer news, which states that Mikel Arteta's Arsenal woes can be solved if Gunners sanction huge January transfer. So the reports are stating that Arsenal finally secured their first win of the season, but Mikel Arteta will want more improvements to his squads. Mikel Arteta would have been the most relieved man in all of North London on Saturday afternoon after finally seeing his Arsenal team find their nets and later secure a 1-0 victory over Norwich. After 3 consecutive defeats without scoring, the Gunners finally got some points on the board thanks to Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang's strike. There was nothing artistic about the goal, nor was there anything spellbinding about the Arsenal display. Aubameyang was on hand to tap home after a goalless scramble, and the goal brought about a sense of relief for desperate Arsenal fans. But their problems are far from being resolved after their worst ever starts of a Premier League season. Mikel Arteta oversaw the biggest expenditure by any club in the summer transfer window with 6 new signings. The deal to sign Ben White from Brighton cost £50 million, while Barcelona got a £35 million move for Real Madrid, and the £30 million transfer of Aaron Ramsdale blew a hole in their budgets. Mikel Arteta had already added Albert Sammy Lokonga and Nuno Tavares to his squad, and even secured a deal for Takehiro Tomiyasu from Bologna for £16 million. The right back made a decent impression on his first outing in the red and white shirts and nearly marked his debut with a goal. But there is a feeling that Arsenal could and should have invested a total £166 million on more high profile players to improve the squad immediately rather than investing for the future. One player who was strongly linked to the move to the Emirates Stadium was Bernardo Silva after falling down the pecking order at Manchester City. The 27-year-old made clear his desire to leave over the summer after 4 years with the champions having arrived from Monaco in 2017. Atletico Madrid had already registered their interest in Bernardo, but Manchester City's £60 million asking price scared off any potential suitors. Considering Arsenal's significant investment this summer, the school of thought is that signing a proven performer such as Bernardo would have been wiser than gambling on Martin Odegaard. The Portuguese showed his quality after being handed his third start of the season by Pep Guardiola against Leicester City. And the playmaker repaid his faith with a deft finish to hand Manchester City the only game of the game at the King Power Stadium on a day where Manchester United and Chelsea both won convincingly. Such a victory was crucial. In truth, the goal only underlined Bernardo's supreme overall performance. He was comfortable in possession, creating chances for his teammates and enjoying a free role in midfield. It is curious that the Portugal international is not a regular figure in Guardiola's plans given his recent performances. But the Catalan head coach, while heaping praise on his performance and expressing his delight that he's staying at the club, admits his long-term future is still unclear. The connection between Bernardo, Jack and Joel was brilliant, he told reporters. It's not just their qualities as players but also their incredible work rate. Bernardo is playing well and we are happy that he stayed. We'll see what happens in the future. That could be all the encouragement also needed if they also reignite a move for Bernardo Silva in the winter transfer window. But if Mikel Arteta could convince Bernardo to become one of the key players at the Emirates, it may go some way to getting the fans back on his side. And I think Bernardo Silva will be a great addition. So we will have to wait and see how Arsenal performs at the end of this season. If you want to see more daily videos from Arsenal News TV, make sure you click the subscribe button, hit the like button so I know if you enjoyed the video, and share the video to your Arsenal friends and family. Click one of the videos on the screen and I'll see you there.